Well, there are plenty of so-called hangover cures, but do they really work? We're busting a few hangover myths now with science journalist Wendy Zukerman. Let's make her welcome. Miss Wendy, I've got to say, we were talking about hangover cures on a Monday. It's a ripping hangover we're trying to cure. What actually happens to us when a hangover hits?
Well, alcohol is a diuretic, so it makes us want to pee. And the reason that it does that is because it blocks this chemical that's in our brain that makes the kidney work. And so the kidney kind of shuts down a little and it says, I don't want to deal with all this fluid, just send it to the bladder. So it really makes us pee a lot. And that means that when we wake up in the morning, we're often incredibly dehydrated and you often have a dry mouth. Mm. And what's happening now is all the organs in the body are saying, I need water, and they steal it from the brain. So the brain shrinks a little and this actually pulls on the skull, giving you this pounding headache.
Oh, my gosh.
That's just one of the things that happens when you have a hangover.
And if you don't get the pounding headache and you don't get all those effects, does that mean that you're lucky or that you...
That means you're an alcoholic.
or does it mean you're an alcoholic?
It's a really good question. And the idea is that probably genetics have a lot to do with it, so perhaps you are given very lucky genes that allow you to break down alcohol really efficiently, and that's why you avoid this pounding headache. Wow.
So you've got some suggestions for so-called cures. What works and what doesn't?
The best thing is your body's dehydrated, it needs fluids. That's the only sort of proven way.
So you have another drink.
Another water drink.
Ah, water.
The hair of the dog is not recommended by anyone. Your liver is rapidly trying to get rid of all this alcohol in your body.
It does take the edge off things.
Take the edge off. So what is the best thing you can do? Everything else has not really been proven or demonstrated by science. But perhaps the egg, there's a little bit of science in the egg. So eggs have cysteine in them, which is this chemical that helps you break down alcohol. So perhaps that might be a little bit useful.
You drink a raw egg?
You can eat a fried egg if you like.
Well, I love doing a Macca's run.
Oh, yes.
Down it, Joe.
No.
Two raw eggs. Go on, I dare you.
I've done my duty.
What about the Macca's run? Does that work?
The Macca's run does not work. In fact, eating fatty foods before you go out drinking is thought to prevent a hangover because it sticks to the stomach lining and it slows down the absorption of alcohol. So doing this before is a good idea. After, this is all kind of a bit of a myth. It's thought that maybe you crave fatty foods because we always crave fatty foods, and when you've got a hangover, your willpower's gone and
you're like, could it be that you've just been drinking for 24 hours and haven't eaten?
Well, that's true as well. Your blood sugar levels often drop because alcohol, not only have you not been eating, you've been drinking, but alcohol does muck around with the way that you break down energy, and so often that's why sometimes you get the shakes.
Or it could be that God wants us to eat fried chicken.
Just look at them.
Pull anything out.
What about that myth that, is it a myth, that you shouldn't mix your drinks, that the way to avoid a hangover is stay on champagne or stay on vodka?
Beer before wine, you wake up feeling fine. Wine before beer, you wake up all queer.
Yeah.
That's a sign.
That's scientific, doesn't it?
Absolutely. There's kind of mixed theories on this, nothing particularly proven. Some say that it's the amount of alcohol you're drinking that matters, so mixing drinks isn't really important. But then others say that your body can maybe get more efficient at breaking down the alcohol if it's only given one poison at a time. Right. So if you stay on the same drink.
You can drink champagne all night and feel awful in the morning. I know.
and carbonated drinks are supposed to be absorbed much faster in your stomach, so they're going to give you a worse hangover, is the thought.
I know the Canadian Air Force...
That's true, actually. Yeah.
The Canadian Air Force was losing pilots because of hangovers. They were horribly hungover and headaches, and they were losing pilots and planes, and did a survey, and they thought the best cure after the hangover was something greasy, bacon and egg rolls, hamburgers. That was their survey a number of years ago.
Wow.
Does that sound...
Well, not too much proven. I mean, there's ideas about why you might want greasy food, but whether it's going to really help you out to release that hangover,
I don't think we should overthink it. I just think ate the bacon and eggs.
One thing that might work, though, is vitamin B, which is in Barocca.
Vegemite.
And Vegemite, exactly. And so while you've been doing all this peeing out, often you pee out multivitamins and minerals and potassium and things like that.
So Vegemite and then the bacon and egg on the sandwich.
And water. Well, Wendy, next time we have our head in the toilet, we'll be thinking of you and your advice. Oh. Wendy Zukerman, thank you very much. Ahead on Studio 10, more stories on how viewers' kids have gotten them into trouble. And Craig Bennett has the showbiz file. What's coming up, Craigie?
I was just thinking of those wicked hangovers we've all endured over the years. Not a good thing, but now we know the cure. Look, the ghost of John Belushi is everywhere. And I'll tell you where. I will tell you why John Voight was not invited to the Rangelina wedding. And Michael Jackson's kids, they've reunited. That is ahead on Studio 10. We will see you back after the break. Don't move.